वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आज वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द 9th स्टैंडर्ड साइंस केमिस्ट्री चैप्टर एटम्स एंड द मॉलिक्यूल्स। इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड विद द मीनिंग ऑफ एटम, हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द एटॉमिक मास, व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन, सो दैट ऑल वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लासेस। सो इन टुडेस क्लास लेट अस लर्न मोर थिंग्स अबाउट द मॉलिक्यूल्स। What is molecule, how to write the molecular formula, that all we are going to discuss in today's class. Yes, as you know students, what is a molecule? We can say molecule is a group of atoms. If you consider, for example, if I consider hydrogen element, so this hydrogen element, as in the previous class we have discussed, it is represented with a capital H. So this hydrogen is having the hydrogen atoms. So group of hydrogen atoms we are going to call as the molecules. And these group of molecules, sorry, atoms, what molecule you are supposed to say, they are representing the same properties of the hydrogen element, right? So if I write for this hydrogen element, if I write H2, what is the meaning students? H2 is one molecule and this molecule is made up of two atoms of hydrogen. This has made up of two atoms of a hydrogen. Oxygen, O2. So O2 is one oxygen molecule which has made up of two oxygen atoms, right? So these atoms are representing the properties of oxygen itself. If I take ozone, O3, then how many atoms have combined to form one oxygen molecule? Three atoms of oxygen. So O plus O plus O. Three oxygen atoms have combined to form one oxygen molecule. Right, students? Yes. Take down the definition of a molecule then. A molecule is the smallest particle of a substance which has the properties of that substance and can exist in the free state. Take down these examples. Next, molecules of a compound. Molecules of a compound. What is molecules of a compound? In the previous class already you have discussed what is the meaning of compounds, right? So when two or more elements chemically combine with each other, they are called as the compound. For example, hydrogen and water. Sorry, hydrogen and oxygen, these two elements, when they have combined chemically in a proper proportion, they used to form as the water, and this water is one compound, right? So if you say water is made up of group of atoms, in this you can find H plus H, two hydrogen atoms are there and one oxygen atom. So group of atoms are called as the molecules. So this is called one water molecule. One water molecule. Means compounds have formed by the group of atoms, nothing but called the molecules. And these are called molecules of a compounds. Molecules of a compounds. For example, hydro HCl. So one hydrochloric acid molecule, right? So one molecule, this is a molecule of a compound. HCl is one compound. It is made up of different types of molecules, right? Carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. Molecule of a carbon dioxide. Ammonia. Molecule of a ammonia, NH3. Molecule of a methane, CH4. So these are the compounds, with the molecules, right? Group of atoms. So one methane molecule, right? So these are called as the molecules of the compounds. Take down the examples, students. Students, the next concept is molecular mass. As you have discussed how to find out the atomic mass, now coming to the next one, that is molecular mass. Again, this can be calculated with the help of the relative mass of that element only. Here also we are going to take the carbon 12 isotope and we are going to compare, that is what called as relative molecular mass. So this can be calculated as molecular mass is mass of one molecule of an element, mass of one molecule of an element two, means by comparing you are going to calculate, to 1/12 mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope. 1/12 the mass of carbon 12 isotope. With this we can find out the molecular mass of the substance. Take down one line, students. The molecular mass of a substance is the relative mass, of its molecule, as compared with the mass of 1/12 mass of carbon 12 isotope. So let us learn how to calculate the molecular mass. So molecular mass can be find out with the help of the atomic mass. Let us learn few sums now. Take the example of the water. How to find out the molecular mass of water? As you know, the formula of the water is H2O. For this we require the atomic mass. Atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. Oxygen is 16. Right? Atomic mass of hydrogen is 1 and atomic mass of oxygen is 16U. So what to do, students? H2O. How many hydrogen atoms are here? 2 hydrogen atoms are there and here is 1 oxygen atom. To calculate its molecular mass, first you have to take the atomic mass of hydrogen, 1 into number of hydrogen atoms, means 1 into 2 plus the atomic mass of oxygen, 16 into number of atoms. Here nothing is written, means 1 will be there. So how many atoms are there? 1. So the molecular mass of water is 18U. Take down, students. Next example, sulfuric acid, H2SO4. Sulfuric acid. Atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. Sulfur is 32. And oxygen is 16. Yes, can you calculate yourself? First you write, what is the atomic mass of hydrogen? That is 1. Into what to multiply? How many atoms of hydrogen are there? Plus sulfur, atomic mass is 32. Into how many atoms are there? 1. Plus oxygen, 16 into 4. So just do the calculations. Students, add all the three, it will be 98 U. So the molecular mass of sulfuric acid is 98 U. So this is the method of calculating the molecular mass of the substances. You have to take the help of the atomic mass. With that you have to find out the molecular mass. Yes students, the next concept is about ions. What is the meaning of ions? Let us start with one example. Let me take the example of the sodium. And sodium, its atomic number is 11. The sodium atomic number is 11. Atomic number is 11 means how many electrons it has, students? It has 11 electrons. So these 11 electrons will distribute in different shells and subshells, and that is known as electronic configuration. What is electronic configuration? The 11 electrons will distribute in different orbits and orbitals or shells and subshells. That is known as electronic configuration. Okay. So let us start with the electrolyting electronic configuration. Already in the previous year we have discussed, the first shell is represented as a K, second L, third M, fourth as a N. Right? The capacity of K shell is 2, L 8, M 18 and N 32. How to remember this? This you can remember with the formula 2N square. N represents the number of shells. For example, third shell I want to find out. I don't remember it is 18. So 2 into number of shell is 3. 3 square. Right? It is a 9 into 2. 18. 18 electrons can accumulate in the third shell. So this K shell with the one subshell, that is S. The subshells are there SPDF. So K shell is with the one subshell, that is S. L with the two subshells, that is S and P. Third with the three, S, P, D. And a fourth with the four, that is S, P, D and F. Okay? Yes. The S capacity is two electrons. S shell, subshell capacity is two electrons. It can accumulate two electrons. It may be the first shell, second, third or fourth. Its capacity will be 2. Right. The second shell, S and a P. P capacity is 6 electrons. It can accumulate 6 electrons. 6 plus 2, 8. So, L capacity is 8. It may be second shell, third or fourth. S capacity is 6. Coming to the next, D capacity is 10, F capacity is 14 and so on. Okay, so this you have to remember to write the electronic configuration. Yes, okay. So let me start with the sodium with 11 electrons. 1s2. Okay, first shell with the S subshell and accumulated 2 electrons. Right? So 11 minus 2. Already you have distributed 2. Now how many are remaining with you? 9 are remaining. Next 2s2 of After filling this one, 1 year, you have to go for 2 years. So 2 years, two. Next, 2B6 under 3S1. This is the electronic configuration of sodium. If you want to write K shell with the 2, L with the 8, this is 1. The third Young shell, 8 plus 2, 10 plus 1, 11 electrons. If you write the sodium atomic structure, this is the nucleus. First shell with the 2 electrons. Second shell, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons. The third shell, how many electrons it has? It has only 1 electron. Right, students? Okay. And as we know, every atom wants 8 electrons in its outermost shell. I'm not talking about these two. It wants 8 electrons in its outermost shell to become stable, to get the octet structure, 2-8, 2-8-8, right? To get the octet structure, it wants 8 electrons in its outermost shell. So here in this case, what happens? 2-8-1, one electron is extra. If it is given out to some other atoms, what happens? It will get the configuration of a 2-8. Right? So, when it will donate this one electron, the sodium will get charged. The sodium atom will get charged. Instead of writing sodium like this, how I will write? Na plus. Sodium will get charged. And this is called ion. This is called as the ion. Hope you are getting, students. So what do you mean by ion? Atoms, they will get some charges. When they are charged, they are called as the ions. So ions again are of two types. Cation and anion. Now in this case, sodium case. Sodium, it has lost or donated one electron to some other atom. It has donated one electron. By donating one electron, it will get the positive charge. It will get the positive charge, and this is called cation. Positively charged ions are called cations. There is one more, that is anion. Anion, nothing but negatively charged ions. Negatively charged atoms are called as the anion. So to know about the anion, let me take one more example, the example of the chlorine. The atomic number of chlorine is 17. Write the electronic configuration like this. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p5. First shell, 2 electrons. Second, 8. 8 plus 2, 10. This is 7. 7b. So you have distributed 7 electrons. 17 electrons you have distributed. Which is the outermost shell, students? Third is the outermost shell. With how many electrons? 7 electrons. Okay. How many it requires to become stable? It requires one more electron to become stable so that it can get the electronic configuration of a 2-8-8 to become octet. So what it will do, instead of donating the 7, it's a huge number, it will receive one electron. It will receive one electron from some other atom. Right? So when it is going to receive, what happens? It is receiving nothing but it has got the charge, that is negative charge, called Cl minus. Called as the Cl minus. Let me draw the chlorine atom. This is the nucleus. First shell with the 2 electrons. Second shell with the 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You can do it to mark or you can do the dot. The third shell with the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 electrons are there. So, 7 electrons are there. It will receive one electron. By receiving, it will get the charge, that is negative charge, and called as the anion. So, ions with the 2 types called as cation and the anion. Positively charged ions are called cations. Negatively charged ions are called anions. When they will become cation? By losing the electrons or by donating the electrons, they will get the positive charge, and by receiving the electrons, they will get the negative charge. Okay, students? So, this is about ions and the types of ions. With this concept, let me tell you one more concept, that is valency. I think during 8th standard we have discussed. Till there, is it visible? Okay. Yes. What is valency? Valency is the combining capacity of that atom. The combining capacity is called as the valency. Now see, coming to the case of sodium. Sodium is going to donate one electron. So what is the valency of the sodium? The valency of the sodium is 1. Okay? And what is the combining capacity of the chlorine? It is receiving one electron. That is the combining capacity. So it is taking one electron. So its valency is 1. Right? So this is the way of finding or the meaning of valency. The combining capacity of an element is known as its valency. Let me take one more example to understand the valency. Which example will take? Oxygen, whose atomic number is 8. Okay, write the electronic configuration first, students. 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Right? 4 plus 2, 6 plus 2, 8 electrons I have distributed. First shell with 2 electrons, second shell with the 6 electrons. How many electrons it requires to become stable? Still, 2 electrons it requires. So, what is the combining capacity of the oxygen? Oxygen combining capacity is 2. So, the valency of oxygen is a 2. Hope you are understanding, students. Yes. Coming back to this example, sodium and the chlorine. Here what happens, this sodium and the chlorine, in sodium one electron it will donate, chlorine will receive one electron. So by donating and by receiving, right, Na plus and a single minus, it is donating one electron, it is receiving one electron. So by this, these are going to form as one compound called sodium chloride, which is neutral. Sodium Na plus Cl minus, both will combine with each other by donating the electrons and receiving. So they have become one compound called as NaCl, and these are called ionic compounds. These are called ionic compounds. Take down the compounds which are made up of ions. Compounds which are made up of ions are called ionic compounds. Example, NaCl, KCl, HCl. It may be MgCl2, magnesium oxide, MgO, CaCO3. So many examples we can do for the ionic compounds. Hope you are taking down, students. Yes, students, the next concept is polyatomic ions. Now you discussed and understood the meaning of ions. So these ions, whatever just now we have discussed, these are called as the simple ions. It may be Na plus, H plus, K plus, Mg plus 2, right? It may be Cl minus. These are all called as simple ions. Now let us learn with polyatomic ions. What do you mean by poly? Poly nothing but the many. Many atoms will form, that is called as polyatomic ions. Let us discuss few examples, you will come to know. Let me take the example of ammonium ion. Ammonium ion. So ammonium ion, its formula is NH4 plus, means what happens, students? Nitrogen, hydrogen, two types of atoms, they have combined with each other and they are one group now. They are one ion, they are representing one ion called as ammonium ion. Again, you can't divide them, right? So this type of ions are called as polyatomic ions. Hydroxide ion, OH minus. Oxygen, hydrogen, both have combined to form one ion, so called as polyatomic ion. Next example, carbonate ion, CO3 minus, carbon, oxygen, both have combined to form one ion, that is called as polyatomic ion, right? Phosphate ion, PO4 minus 3, that is one polyatomic ion. Students, take down the examples and let me dictate, take down the definition of the polyatomic ion. Right now, ions which are formed from groups of atoms are called polyatomic ions. So this is about the ions, students. So what are all the topics we have discussed? Ions nothing but when atoms will get some charge, either positive charge or negative charge. When they will get the charge, we will call them as the ions. With the two types, cations and the anion. Positively charged ions are called cation. By losing the electrons, they will get the cation, means positive charge. By gaining the electrons, they will get the negative charge, that is called anion. These two concepts we have discussed. We discussed with the valency. What is valency? The combining capacity of the elements, that is called as the valency. We discussed with the ionic compounds. When ions will combine with each other to form a compound, that is called as the ionic compound. With this, we discussed with the polyatomic ions. If many atoms will combine to form one ion, those are called as the polyatomic ions. Okay, take down. Okay, students, Remaining we will discuss in our next class. Okay, thank you.